Level Best Books presents The Counterfeit Candidate, written by Brian Klein, read by John Chancer. Prologue. According to accepted 20th century history, on the 30th of April 1945, Adolf Hitler and Eva Braun said their final goodbyes to a small group of close friends and colleagues who were gathered in a sitting room deep inside the underground bunker in Berlin. The pair retired to the Fuhrer's personal study, where a few hours later they took their own lives. Braun bit down on a wafer-thin glass cyanide ampoule, and Hitler shot himself in the right temple, using his own Walter PPK pistol. The bodies were then carried above ground, via the bunker's emergency exit, and buried in the Reich Chancellery garden, after being doused in petrol and set alight. 36 hours earlier, the couple had married in a simple ceremony, where they declared they were of pure Aryan descent and free of hereditary disease. The only witnesses were the Minister of Propaganda, Josef Goebbels, Party Secretary Martin Bormann, and the Fuhrer's personal valet, Heinz Linge. The ceremony was followed by a modest lunch of spaghetti and tomato sauce, one of the Fuhrer's favorite meals, prepared by his personal chef, Constanze Manziarli. Hitler was dressed in full Nazi uniform, and Braun wore a calf-length black dress, broken up by a print of small white roses around the neckline. The Fuhrer then dictated his last will and testament, in which he declared he chose death over capitulation, and left his vast personal fortune to the Nazi Party. 3 months after the Nazi regime declared unconditional surrender, the victorious political leaders met in the German city of Potsdam, just outside Berlin, for a post-war conference to discuss the new order in Europe. On the 17th of July, 1945, Stalin and Truman sat down for an intimate lunch in one of the small banqueting suites inside the spectacular Sizilienhof Palace. The only people present were their respective foreign secretaries, Molotov and Burns, who acted as translators. Truman was astonished when Stalin disclosed that rumors of the discovery of Hitler and Braun's bodies were fabricated, and that a painstaking search by his Red Army soldiers of the Reich Chancellery grounds had failed to discover any sign of the Fuhrer's remains. Stalin was convinced Hitler had escaped his clutches. Chapter 1. The 6th of January, 2012. Buenos Aires. The tunnel was almost finished. It had taken three hugely determined men 8 months to construct, and ran straight from the basement of the Café Torino directly underneath the safe depository of the Banco Estero. The eminent bank was one of the oldest in Argentina, and stood imperiously on Avenida Cabildo, deep in the heart of the fashionable Belgrano district of Buenos Aires, in the northeast of the city. The 100-foot tunnel had state-of-the-art ventilation, sensor-activated lighting, and pure wool carpet flooring. The enormous underground structure was a magnificent feat of engineering. The small gang had worked every night and weekend for 8 months, and between them had moved over 4,500 cubic feet of dirt, making nearly 3,000 wheelbarrow trips. Pedro Garcia rested the drill by the side of the newly formed earth wall. He stopped chewing, carefully removed the gum from his mouth, and stared up at the 12-inch-thick concrete ceiling, appreciating they had finally reached the floor of the depository. Pedro allowed himself a rare smile as he stroked his straggly salt-and-pepper beard. He hadn't shaved since the very first day the drilling had begun.
"Guys, this is it. We are standing directly underneath 1,200 beautiful boxes, and God only knows what's inside them."
One of his two comrades leapt across the shag pile carpet and bear-hugged his leader.
"I'll tell you what's in them. New lives for all of us."
Ricardo Gonzalez was the youngest of the three robbers, and by far the most impetuous.
"Pedro, you said we would do it, and we have. I love you, old man." Ricardo.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.